In this video, we are going over the male reproductive model. We're going to go ahead and do a quick orientation to kind of orient us on the body. So this is going to be the anterior view with the penis. This is going to be the inferior view with the scrotum. This is going to be the superior view with the bladder. And this is going to be the posterior view with the rectum. So we're going to start from the posterior side and move forward. We're going to start with this structure right here, number 5. This is the seminal vesicle. We know that it's going to be posterior to the bladder, and it coordinates, or I would say just shares the same duct as the ductus deferens. You may have heard that as the vas deferens. But this is the seminal vesicle. This is going to be the duct that it shares with the deferens. So next, we're going to go ahead and move to the actual ductus deferens, and we're going to talk about the ampulla. The vas deferens. It's going to be this structure number 4 right here. And we know ampulla is going to be wide. And since this is the actual connection to the ejaculatory duct, which is this is the ejaculatory duct right here, that explains why we're going to want a larger opening at that portion. Next, we're going to have the ejaculatory duct, which I've been talking about for a while now, is going to be number 6 right here. It connects both the ductus deferens and the seminal vesicle to the urethra. And we know that this ejaculatory duct runs through the prostate. And we can see how inflammation would affect this structure. Next, we're going to have the prostate itself, which we were just pointing at, is number 7. And the prostate, we know that the prostate makes about 25 to 30% of seminal fluid, and it's about 4 by 3 centimeters in size, as well as 2 centimeters deep. And we know that it secretes that fluid, and that fluid actually has antibiotic properties, which is pretty cool. Keeps bacteria out of the urethral tract during ejaculation and otherwise in just general life. We're going to notice something that So we're going to go a little more posterior, and we're going to see the bulbul urethral gland here, number 8. And the bulbul urethral gland, we know it's about pea-sized, or 1 centimeter in diameter, this little structure right through here. And we know that it, too, secretes a fluid. It secretes alkaline fluid, though, into the urethra, so you can see through here. And that helps neutralize urine, since we know that urine is going to be quite acidic. And that aids in keeping the urethra lubricated, as well as keeping sperm from being damaged by the acidity of urine that may be left in the urethral tract. So we're going to move to number 9. And so if you look at the diagram, it says number 9 is all of this. They call all of that the urethra, which is true. But the urethra is actually broken up into 3 segments. The first segment is going to be the prostatic urethra, which you can tell by the name, means the urethra that's going to be surrounded by the prostate itself. And so we can see how the prostate, which is right here, that surrounds the urethra, if it inflames or becomes diseased, how that could actually affect urine output through the actual urethral tract. So next we're gonna see the intermediate urethra, which so we know the prostate urethra goes to here, and the intermediate urethra or membranous urethra is about half a centimeter basically long. It's really short. It sits in the muscular floor of the pelvis. And and it's just kind of short. Next, we're going to have, we're going to move back up to the ductus deferens. And so, I guess I'd say to the anterior side. So we know that the ductus deferens is going to be this tube, a.k.a. vas deferens. You may have heard, just like the vasectomy. And so we know that the ductus deferens starts at the end of the epididymis, right? So the epididymis is here. And then this tract, which runs all the way up, and connects to the ejaculatory duct, is going to be the ductus deferens. And we know that it transfers sperm from the testes out of the body. And next, we're going to move to the epididymis. Oh, by the way, actually, I should probably mention. So we know that to get the sperm out of here, right, we know that it somehow has to move. And we know that it moves through peristaltic contractions, this motion that kind of pushes it up and out. So next, the epididymis, which we were just talking about, it's going to be this kind of curly Q area right through here. You'll see it's most likely referred to as shaped as a comma. We know it's about 4 centimeters long, and the major portion of it is that it leads to sperm maturation inside here. And so that leads us to the testes, the star of the show. So we know that testes is the male gonad. We know that it produces sperm inside here, while that sperm matures here, but it gets produced inside here, and hormone gets secreted from here. And we know that they're actually going to be housed in the scrotum themselves. And the scrotum is obviously going to be external to the body, where the testes and epididymis lay. And but so how does it get, right? So why, what's holding it here, essentially? And we're going to have a muscle as well as the spermatic cord. And the spermatic cord is a fibrinous connective tissue that holds this structure. So it includes the ductus deferens, the nerves, the veins, the arteries, those vessels. It's going to hold all of this. And it looks like this tissue here, and actually attaches it into the pelvic area. And so next, we're going to move a little more external now. And we're going to talk about the penis itself. So we know that this structure right through here is going to be the penis. We know that it is made of spongy. Actually, I'll talk about something else. Remember we talked about the urethras, right? We talked about the prostatic urethra, the intermediate or membranous urethra. Then we're going to have spongy urethra. And the reason why it's spongy urethra is it's actually going to have to pass through the spongy spongiosum, which is going to be this tissue right through here. And that's what's actually going to swell with blood during excitation. So we know that there's one other structure to kind of, well, a couple of the structures to go over, actually. So we're going to talk about the glans penis, because it's number 13, which is kind of hard to see, but it's actually going to be the structure right through here. We know that we're going to have the capora cavernosa, which is going to be this structure right through here. And that just means main hollow body. But lastly, we're going to talk about the pubic symphysis, and that's going to be right there. So yeah, that was just a quick overview. If we want more in detail, those videos can come later.